Okay, so today what we're going to do is have a look at trying to create a drum beat for your remix. So this really is where you can be start to be really creative. So I'm going to press the plus at the bottom, and you really have quite a few options when it comes to drums. If you remember when we did Riptide, lots of you, you used the Smart Drums, or you might have used the Beat Sequencer. For this, you can use the Beat Sequencer, Smart Drums, Acoustic Drums, whatever you want. I'm gonna have a go at using the Acoustic Drums, just because I want a bit of a challenge of trying to play something in time. but it's totally up to you. Now, you can choose the drum kit that you like. Maybe a Bluebird is like a classic. But remember, what you can do if you want to is you can choose an electronic drum kit, which obviously will be completely different, but you do actually get to try to do it in time, which is quite good. It depends on what kind of style you want, really, for your own remix. If you want like a dance style, or if you want a more kind of acoustic-y kind of rock style, very much depending on what you you know, what kind of feel you're going for. So I'm gonna go back just to the Bluebird for the moment, just to have a go at trying to put in something quite simple, maybe something like that. So I'm just gonna see what that sounds like with my track. That's most important thing, is just to keep trying things out, really. Going to listen to the bass line through first, and then I'm going to add in. Okay, that was okay. It wasn't brilliant, but it was something. Let me just see if I can try now going to more of an electronic drum kit and see what that sounds like. See, when you play these drums, what that does is it gives it a completely different feel, which is kind of, you know, you need to decide what kind of style you like. So let's just have a go at this. Kind of experimenting, listening to what the different instruments sound like. Now, the other thing that you can do, obviously, is you don't have to do these actual drums. What you could do is you could actually just do the Smart Drums or the Beat Sequencer. And I know some of you have had a go at doing the Beat Sequencer last time. And with this, what you're effectively doing is just putting in the beats, and then it plays it through. So with this one, what you can do is obviously, you know, turn the lights on and off to create the beat that you like. So if you're happy with it, obviously what you then do is make sure that your little locator is right back at the beginning, and then you can record it in. And I would just record it in for one lot of the 8 bars, then you can loop it or copy and paste it. So sorry, that was 4 bars, not 8 bars. Okay, so then you can go back, use your brick wall to go back. Now what you might decide is you don't want that in at the beginning, and that's fine. So I'm just going to put that there. So now I've got kind of a gradual start. So let's just listen to what that sounds like now. And remember, if you pull out this section here, what you can do is change the overall volumes of the different tracks, which might be quite useful if the drums are a bit too loud. So I'm going to make my bass line a bit louder, because that's, I suppose, the star of the show, the bass. Pull those down a little bit, the chords. So you're mixing it as you go, really. So you can see that the drums really give it a completely different feel, and you might think, oh, okay, that I don't know if that really works with the keyboard, with the piano playing the chords there. I think it's like a bit of a strange difference. So what you might want to do is go back and just change the instrument for this one once you've done it, and that's quite easy to do as well. Okay, so you can just to go in there. Just change the instrument, it's quite easy. So you might want a synth part instead of a piano. Okay, I'll let you experiment there.